Mommy.
Mommy nearest?
Yeah. She's in town and I wanted to hang out.
Years later,
later, he decided to marry her younger sister, Matilda. They would have 8 more children together. However, 2 of them died as infants, and 1 daughter died at the age of 6. Their most famous son was Maurice Sorel. He became the youngest general in the Confederate Army at the age of 26. He wrote one of the most famous Civil War books, Recollections of a Confederate Staff Officer, and he was featured in the movie Gettysburg. Francis built his home for Matilda in the late 1830s. They became the toast of the town, and there were many grand parties within this home. They say one afternoon in 1860, Matilda went looking for one of her head servants named Molly. Most of the servants had quarters on the second floor of the carriage house, and Molly had a private room there. When Matilda opened the door to Molly's room, she found Molly in the arms of her husband, Francis. Matilda rushed back into the main house and out onto the upper balcony. Then in a fit of anger and depression, she threw herself into the courtyard, landing head first and dying instantly. 2 weeks later, Molly is found in her room, hanging from a rope in the carriage house rafters. They tried to write this off as suicide back then. However, it is believed that Molly was murdered in the act of revenge or cover-up. 10 years later, Francis died at the age of 77. On the day of his funeral, many of the businesses in town closed in his honor. Were all of the women Francis loved taken away because of his curse? We may never know. However, it does seem that the spirits still spend time here inside the home that he called Shady Corner.
Good job.
Thank you.
Yes,
very good.
They are saying that there's some sort of activity.
crystal clear. My earbuds, using this highly sensitive recording device, I hear a crystal clear female response saying, "Hello. Who are you?"
Thank you. him first. He's a good kid, seems like it. But he is a Marine, so that's a drawback.
Weird.
Hold on. Fair enough.
Where are you from?
Where am I? Originally? Well, my dad was federal marshal when we moved around from. I was born in Seattle.
I do think he was up pulling his car in Marsh. And like,
I was just messing with him.
Thank you.
On your phones, if you can, if you got a iPhone, it can be voice memo. Use that to record with your audio. What I recommend doing, since everybody's a couple. What you do is one records audio, the other does pictures off their phone. That way the phone's not, it's not somebody going to do anything on their phone.
I have an iPhone.
If you got an Android, it's whatever audio program you have on there. If it's like live video, pictures, videos, take lots of pictures. You can actually do the picture motion and bang it out, whatever the heck you call it here. Millennials. It's motion, it's a picture that has motion.
It moves for like a second, so you get like a little
movement. So you can do that. And then once you get everything set up on your phone, please put it on airplane mode. It sends data bytes every 5 minutes, and when it does send data, it can trigger some of the equipment. The only thing that you will still be able to get are regular phone calls and standard text messages. You just won't be able to get data messages.
So you
said to
put it on airplane mode?
Okay. And you got an Android?
No, iPhone.
Okay, if one, I don't know if you were still back there.
Yeah.
One record and one take pictures. However you want to do it, it's called voice memo. It's usually in your extras.
Yep.
So one of y'all decide who wants to do what, and then that way y'all want to.
Do
y'all get an Android? What's the video? There's a bunch of millions of them.
One that I really like called Smart Recorder.
You have downloaded it real quick.
Yeah, and, I mean, it's free. And it's really good job.
Are you suggesting you record the whole time, or just when you ask questions?
The whole time.
Oh, we did lunch first.
No, I mean, you don't have to record me. I'm talking about when you're
No, yeah. No, we just don't have much battery left.
It just expands out the closer it gets to it. The thing about these, it also shows regular energy output. Okay, outlets, fans, air conditioning systems, microwaves, anything like that will cause these to go off. Also, your head on your phone if it's going. This gets brighter. I'm going to have to kill you for a second. But this one, some of y'all might not be able to hear it.
Driving you crazy.
and then you're going to end up with a bunch of audios listening back to, for 2 hours.
Okay.
And that's going to make you mad because then you're going to
just power it down after each.
Yeah, just power it down after 5 minutes.
Okay.
All right. And then.
That's fine.
You can turn it off, making sure, because you can show them over there. Then you said after you turn it on,
you'll see under the red dot, you got reverse sweep. So that's when you press and pull it, it'll start sweeping.
All right. And you set it down.
And just put it down. And put an audio recording device close to it so that way it picks it up. Right? Because it is going to be hard to hear. Your mic, the mic, something that comes across, you might miss it. And that way, if you're recording, you'll be able to catch it. And hear it later when you go back to your audio. Alright. Next piece of equipment, laser grid. This will be in the basement. Please do not point this in people's eyes. Alright? It is a laser grid, and we don't want anybody else to go home with glasses on tonight. What this allows, and what the theory is, and it actually does work, but it's not really a theory, when they move, and they move through it, it brings them out in 3D. So basically, you'll be able to see their shape, and it comes out closer to you, and it dots. So if you got the dots right here, and they walk through it, it brings them out like that. It brings the dots closer to you. So you'll be able to see them as they move. Alright?
Is there somebody already upstairs?
No, there's nobody upstairs.
You heard that too?
Yeah.
Oh, I heard that.
It was something just
with
the boom up there.
Is that upstairs?
Yeah.
Joe?
Yeah, right up here.
Did you knock something over?
I heard it right.
Huh?
Yeah, like
here.
Right back
here. Yeah.
No, it's upstairs.
Like
it's
up
there.
Yeah.
I heard it.
Go to the upstairs camera real quick.
Okay, I saw that. I heard that.
Knock something up there.
Right?
You heard it right.
Upstairs. right, just until we're done. I'm going to leave this fan and AC going. They don't shut it off until we're done. Don't worry, you will not fall through the floor. It's been here for 200 years. Got everybody?
I'm coming.
You heard the stories up here, so.
Oh, yeah.
This large area here, this was a slave common area. It wouldn't be unheard of for a
All right, it was October 7, 1779, one of the bloodiest battles here in Savannah took place. The siege of Savannah, right here in front of the house. At each entrance coming into Savannah, the British had occupied two barracks at each entrance. Most of them being enlisted barracks, but of one location, there was actually an officer's barracks, which stood right where this house is. We found out about the officers when they were doing some digging. But guess what else they found? The bones that he must have been watching the film.
What?
No, you watched the videos. He said, no, you just looked online.
Yeah.
But they did. The uniforms were wrapped around the bodies for the bones that they found. There was 12 different sets. Those 12, not all. You're not going to see all 12. Now, what you will notice is they do walk around in here and move around in here, and they also move back through here, but it looks like they walk through the wall. It's possible the British barracks didn't have a wall there, so they're just retracing the steps that was there. These are not residual because they interact. What's that?
That was not my question. Did you pay attention to it?
No. There are two residual anomalies down here, or what is known to be considered residual. One, she's about yay tall. She'll manifest over here. She'll come up the stairs, stop, turn, disappear, excuse me. She's been captured twice. Both times without flash, so we recommend if you're down here and you see her, be quick about it, get you a picture. The red light stays on for safety reasons. Dark shadow. If you're looking this way, if you're happen to be upstairs looking down and you see her, you'll see her features. It's really weird.
Or can you clarify residual?
Residual? A residual energy is something that repetitively does the same thing over and over and over. It's just the same thing over and over. It's supposed to be a same time, same date, same everything. But the way they're defining residual anymore is does the same thing over and over.
Like they always see them in that spot or go there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Me, residual means it's done on the same day, at the same time, year after year after year after year. It might only happen one time every year.
Like
that's
that
residual.
Experience.
Right. But because of leap years and days, changes and stuff like that, it might have been in April the first time, but then it might be in November that time. That's my belief of what residual is. The other one, he'll just appear right here in the middle of the staircase and get up to the top platform and disappear. That's it. It looks like he's got a long black trench coat on. I have no clue who he is. That's all those two do. The rest of these anomalies down here do move around. This is where the glasses get pulled off your face. You'll see things coming at the side of you, trying to reach for you. That's in this area down here. That's why the laser grid will be here, so you can set it up. It'll last about 6 minutes of continuous use. Then the batteries will be
This is called a REM pod. It is a touch device. It has two other devices within the same device. So it's three devices in one. There's a temperature probe, environmental probe, and the touch device. This little light back here, not that one, but the little one right there, it does blue and red. It's a temperature probe. It just lets you know if the temperature increases or decreases. Sometimes it'll flash real quick, sometimes it'll hold steady. It means that the temperature's doing something. That is it. Anomalies do make the temperatures change in here, either going up or down, depending on the anomaly type. If it goes red, temperature's up. If it goes blue, temperature's decreasing. It'll flash and do all kinds of stuff. That means nothing except temperature changes. That is it. There's a tone, like when we came in here, you heard the tone going off. It's an environmental probe. It lets you know if the environment's changing. Humidities, barometric pressures, et cetera, that has to do with the environment. Anomalies do change the environment. Did you hear that?
You heard that too?
I saw it.
What?
Something just blacked this window out right over here.
It sounded like a door.
Hey, Gordon.
Uh-oh. What's up?
The moment you said that, I saw an orb fly across the surgery room in the camera.
Sweet. Sweet. Oh, this is the room they banged on the door on you. Scared you, didn't it?
Yes, sir.
What do those windows lead to? Those windows, that goes out to Harris Street.
A walkway.
A walkway out there.
Okay. It goes from window to window, then? If you don't see something in that window, we'd have seen it there, too?
Yeah.
Okay.
Unless they stopped right in front of the house.
Well, somebody just walked that way, I saw them.
Okay.
And they didn't block out that window, like what I just saw.
There's no telling in this house. All right, so first activity of the night. Noises, and the guy on the watching the video saw something fly right past in this room at the same time. So that's cool. Yes, right there. So he heard, saw everything. Cool. All right. This room. So touch device part. We got the environment. We got that touch device. Metal rod. I don't ever call it an antenna because it's these anomalies and the way that works. If they were born in the 1800s, if you say you need to make the light turn on by touching the antenna, I'm not sure if they know what an antenna is. I usually use, depending on the time frame, metal rod or antenna, but metal rod here, sticking out of the device or the item sitting on the stool. Now, reason why this room has so much activity in it. This, anybody in the medical field? You? Nurse? Really?
Nurse school.
Oh, you're in school.
Well, I'm starting medical.
You started medical? Congratulations.
Thank you.
Have fun. You might learn about the tourniquet.
Mm-hmm.
The tourniquet started in this room. Frank Sorrell, this guy here, was a prominent surgeon here in Savannah. He did a lot of experimenting. The tourniquet was one of them. It started right here in this room. So with experiments and experimenting on patients, unfortunately, a lot of bad things happened too. A lot of death. And during that time frame, the devil's disease or yellow fever was also coming out, breaking out here in Savannah. There was a lot of death. 10% of the population of Savannah was wiped out by yellow fever alone. Savannah, the city, from where the squares are, is nothing but one entire gradient. Lots of death.
shadow figures?
You won't see much of, except for the one, and I'll tell you about, I already told you something about her. But shadow movement you will see coming from this door going this way. I call that the door of death. I believe that's where most of his dead patients went out. That door over there. It seems like they're trying to get back through this door, but can't quite make it. And they just try, keep trying. I heard footsteps. Did anybody else hear that? It sounded like something out there walking. Almost quite sure.
Well, I do.
All right. So, the thermal camera is going to be right here. There's a lot of activity that happens in here. This is where our little 8-year-old starts. Over here. If you see her, ask her to play hide and seek. That's when she'll go hide under a piece of furniture. She might not get you. She might get another team somewhere in this house.
Tonight?
We don't know.
Don't know.
We're here at 8.
She thought she was alive. So this, and this is just recently. But she does still play the game, but she'll hide somewhere upstairs or down here, and she'll wait for somebody to come by, and she'll grab them or grab the back of their legs. If she doesn't do that, you will see her still. If she's going to play, she'll disappear right there in front of you. If she's going to stay, she might answer questions. The only bad thing is, when she's done answering questions, done for the night. She's a little stubborn, little punk. She'll answer 1 for no, 2 for yes. She does great with it too. But when she starts setting all the lights off, that means she's bored.
What term did you use to get her to talk? Like metal rod?
A metal rod on the stool. Brilliant black circle. You can't miss it. Even in pitch black, you could not miss it. Darkness within darkness. Alright. No, that's a pre-Civil War bone saw and stuff they would have used in this time, in that time frame.
It's pretty cool.
Oh, what's the matter? Oh, y'all remember, it's a full moon. Oh, I'm not adding any fear. Dang, everybody's walking out here. Let me get out of here.
What's up?
Do
people feel any sort of chest pain from
the upstairs?
Yeah, not the main floor, but the highest one.
The highest?
The one next to the room. I'm sorry, I don't remember her name.
Molly?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
A lot of chest, a lot of nausea.
I felt that upstairs, and I felt better when I got down.
It gets,
I was like, okay.
The more she gets pushed, the more higher she gets.
Okay.
All right, let's head on upstairs.
Thank you.
know that all three devices are going off at the same time. What you'll hear out here of one lot of activity is split sticks and running back and forth. Most of the time it's right in here where that happens. So if you're standing around there, don't be surprised something runs past you, bumps you in the back or pushes you out of the way or something like that. But you'll hear a lot of that out here.
Thank you.
this cabinet is uneven, so it does rattle a little bit. One thing they like to do is if they find somebody they like to play with, they're standing close to that cabinet right there, they'll pop the door open on you. You know, hit you in the back of the legs. Don't think it's a little girl, but they pop that door open every once in a while. Okay. Any questions? No? Who's our teams? All right, you guys stay here, you guys go to the basement. Yep, there's one up there, and there's one over here. And there's also one in the hallway. Don't worry, we got you covered.
Yes, yeah, you just ask a question and you wait for a response. Yes.
Do you want to ask again the second question?
Whoever is in here, can you please close the door? Can you tell us your name? How old are you?
Thank you.
chair?
Nationwide.
touch it, please?
Thank you.
four of us down here.
We're all the way down right there?
Yeah. Yeah.
Hey or a hello or something like that over here.
something if you're up here.
Thank you.
if I keep it how I grew.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody in here want to talk with us? Yeah, facing this way. Maybe you might face another way then. Do you like her? Is that why you're hanging around her, trying to put that nice smell of cologne? I'm saying, how often do you and then you hit me right there?
I know you said that
earlier. No, I see the smell from there. It is over here now.
Sir, did the guy on the video camera happen to catch the cabinet door open because it opened the bar?
Thank you.
Can you maybe tug my hair a little bit?
All right, now that we got just men over here, what's going on?
If there's somebody in here, can you tap the bell rod? Twice?
Can we drink?
Oh, yes. Can you open that cabinet door for me?
Yeah.
have it for us?
I don't think they can do it again. They probably can only do it like once a night.
Maybe somebody else in my frequency or something.
Bang!
I feel like, well, that was so loud.
Don't leave
see me scared. You guys feel it. Did you guys hear that?
We got your attention.
When the staircase closed here, it got right in that area. Oh.
What was it?
It was like
out when we heard the noise and
no,
he came on the radio and said...
No, it was something entirely different. I was like, I don't think that's what you guys described it as, but... But I heard the... You know, when we were all down there, the... To me, it sounded like... That's the sound I heard behind when we all saw the orb go by. I mean when...
Where did you hear that? Where did you hear that?
I heard it one more time when we were down... I was down there with Joseph.
In
the basement.
Oh, okay.
In the surgery room.
I heard something like that up here. But it sounded male to me. It's like... Not like... But it definitely didn't sound like a woman, you know? Like, and it was after we were leaving. You know, we were fixing to come down the steps, and I heard something.
Up in Molly's quarters, it felt like every time I breathed, it was sharp pain, and then I went back in, it was gone. So I was like, well, she doesn't like me. Someone doesn't like me up there. That's about the end of it for me. What about you guys?
Well, when we were upstairs with the little voice box, I heard the tell between, like, what sounded like radio interception versus, like, actual response to our questions, but there was one time I just said, were you murdered? And it was like, yes.
Cool.
Yeah.
That was the only one I felt like sure it was the reply. It was like, yes. And then there was like a cry.
There was
a cry. But the other one kind of sounded like just a little radio.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah. Anyone else hear a cry?
Well, we'll go to you guys. Let's go to you guys. Tell us about y'all's night.
The only thing I had was in the parlor, in the men's room, sitting on the couch against this wall, and something played with my leg, and I could feel static with your leg hair. So he was sitting across from me. I told him to come sit with me, and he started feeling it. And I told them about it as we were switching, just in case they might feel it. But it felt like, you know, you take a balloon and you rub it on your.
Oh yeah.
Our leg hairs were doing that the whole time. Like sitting
in our legs.
Because we were all in the ladies' parlor, so we left the ladies in the ladies' parlor. We went and set them in.
Huh.
But I sat on the couch over here, and the whole time it was playing with my leg. I could feel fingers every now and then. It felt like, but it felt more like a balloon, like you got building up static.
He asked me to come over and sit with him. I'll set the table. Chairs beside, and I come over and started doing the same thing. Cool. And then I got a little activity up here with the tattoo. And in this corner where the chair sat right in that area, I got some.
Well, that might have been, that could be that powerful outside that caused that.
Not one of that.
But there's no telling how many. Sometimes it does, sometimes it doesn't.
with a hat on. And the hat was one of those that come down, you know, like Gilligan's Island type hat. But it was a brown color. And it had something long right in here.
Smell like the lavender stuff.
No,
it's something called
It seemed to follow her.
Well, the last group that smelled it that I had says it kind of smelled like old English.
That's exactly it. Like I said, it's something that my grandfather, I would remember from my grandfather, maybe my great grandfather.
Yeah.
You know, Aquadome or whatever. You know, it you did smell older. Yeah. It's not something that any of us would be using in
your car. Or
the cabinet opened. I mean, I heard something and I looked over and I said, put the tag on light over there. And
that guy's over to you and you guys with the cabinet open.
Did you see, did you have a video of it opening?
Yeah,
it's on YouTube. It'll be on the YouTube.
Oh, yeah. Did they shut it? Did y'all shut it?
Yeah, we shut it after we.
Well, it was open while we was up there, too. So I didn't know if it was.
His cane bumped it, and then I shut it.
Oh, okay. That's what it was.
Yeah.
The chair moved in the surgery room again. It moved a few times, and then I told
you, if he don't like it, he'll try to move that sucker back.
I moved and made it very, very sturdy since we were the first group down there. Just in case it moved again, there was no way. And I mean, if you catch no video, I made sure that there was no rocking. So if it didn't move for y'all, you and me pissed him off. He must have left.
Well, overall, everybody had a good time?
Yeah.
Y'all gonna come back again?
Yes.
Yeah, maybe.
I know it'll be a while for you guys. So, I enjoyed tonight. I had fun. I'm glad you guys came and had fun. I hope you guys come back. We do all-night investigations. They're every other month. July and September are booked up. November is the next one.
Oh, thank God.
Cool.
Exactly.
One suggestion. PK actually came up with this. We need to put as much movement and stuff as we felt in collars. Try one of the laser grids, another laser grid up there.
Well, I do have Sega boards. I normally put one up there, but I thought, well, we're kind of.
The way it felt, I think we, because he even saw a shadow up there, you know, at one point in time. We saw a light flash somewhere. I mean, I think we would have been seeing some stuff, because we didn't catch. Anybody catch anything downstairs with the. We didn't out there outside of the other room. We didn't.
One thing I do ask is if you are a TripAdvisor guru, if you don't mind stopping by and giving us a review on that, we greatly appreciate it. That kind of keeps us with our sponsorship here, so that we can continue. Bad reviews, as expected, every once in a while. Somebody can be unhappy because of the minority group or something like that. But, you know, if we can get some good reviews, it would also be nice. But, you know, like I said, it helps us keep our sponsorship here. If you don't mind stopping by there and throwing up a review, tell them about what you did tonight. It also helps future guests. And that's the main thing, keep people coming. You know, it's like, I think we were talking. It was like 7:30, and there's only 5 tickets sold. 7:30 today, this evening, 5 tickets sold, and it booked up. It booked quick, so you know we. And the better, more reviews we get, the better it is for people to come and join us and do the same thing. And tell your friends, yell about it. If y'all got any stateside friends, make sure you let them know. Hey, y'all need to go down here and do this. But we hope you know, guys, everybody comes back. I hope you enjoyed it. It'll take probably about an hour for the video to render once it's done. and then you'll be able to watch it. And you can watch the cabinet open.
Yeah.
And you can watch, listen for the chair.
Yeah, it'll be a chair.
I'll help the chair in the video.
Yeah, it's in the video.
It's in the video.
It wasn't like a big movement, though. You know what I mean? It was just like
it's a
nudge in it to me.
You can hear the reaction.
You should be the one.
Now, the one thing is,
I'm glad. That's all I have.
caught up.
After the chair moved,
I mean, it scared the hell out of me, too.
But if you do get any evidence, if when you get home and when you leave tonight, you go back, listen to your audios, and look at your pictures, and watch a little any videos that you might have did on your phones, if you want us to take a look at them, you can send them to me through Savannah Paranormal on that page, or you can send them to the Sorrel Weed House at sorrelweedhouse@gmail.com. That's right.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And email it to them, and they'll take a look at it.
I think it's official SWA, so official SWA.
Yeah.
Hey, I apologize for saying a curse word. I said one.
But other than that, unless anybody has any questions,